Hey, what's up? How you doing? And today I talk about the Canon RF 85mm 2.0 macro lens. And I apologize if you're scaring a spider, but I think this picture is fantastic with this lens on the Canon EOS R5. And I will let you know in this video the pros and cons about this lens. But let me tell you first that I really enjoy to make this kind of photography. I never used to make macro photography. I'm an amateur, so if you have tips and tricks, link below in the comments, write me down which aperture do you use or what are your settings in the camera if you're doing macro photography. I really respect people who are making animal photography or macro photography with insect or all these flowers. Yeah, I said, why I have to film or why I have to make photos from flowers or insects? But now, when I saw the result, I'm impressed. It's another world. You can show pictures. It's amazing. You have really other pictures than before. So let us talk about pros and cons. Pro is you can purchase this lens for 700 euro, but it shipped without the lens hood. And I am a big fan of lens hood because this is, for me personally, the best protection you have for your lens. Build quality is nice. It's about plastic, but it's a great quality. I wouldn't complain about this. And the pictures with this lens are really awesome. It's amazing. I really can't say any bad about image quality. This lens making really great high rich quality pictures. This is the con. The noise is a little bit, for me, annoying, but I'm used to accept this. But the autofocus is super fast. It's really super fast on, especially with the Canon EOS R5. But when you switch to video mode, it's absolutely silent. So that's also a good advantage. You don't hear this noise because it's not necessary to have a noise when you're filming. So now I put the Atomos Ninja 5 recorder on the Canon EOS R to show you how fast is the autofocus with the RF 85mm. It's also very nice that you have the image stabilization on the RF 85mm up to 5 stops. And that helps a lot, especially with 85mm. You know, normally I used mostly 15 to 35 a wide angle lens. That's much more easier to hold your camera steady. But the RF 85mm or 100 or 200mm is quite difficult. But the image stabilization also on this lens is great. So in a couple of days I will take my cameras and the different Canon lenses to Paris. Maybe you heard about the artwork from Christo and Jean-Claude Wrapped. That's for sure an amazing trip. So that's why I hope and highly appreciate if you subscribe my channel that you don't miss this series about my trip to Paris. That's today from my side. I hope you liked the video. I hope you learned something from the video. If you ask me to make a decision if I have to buy the RF 85mm again, yes, I would do buy this lens again. I'm very happy, I'm satisfying, and I hope to see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Peace.